This is an 1860 Baldwin steam locomotive. Wood and later coal was used for fuel. Water to make steam was carried in the adjoining tender. What does this engine weigh? Well, the engine and tender is 126,490 pounds. That's roughly 63 tons. The engine only weighs 93,960 pounds. That's 47 tons. The engineer held the throttle in his left hand. Overhead is the whistle lever. Sorting mail on moving trains was one of the Postal Service's great inventions. After the Civil War, post office officials worked to decentralize operations and concentrating on growing volume of mail carried on the nation's rail lines. Mailbags left untouched on the rail car floors were now emptied and their contents processed as the train sped towards its destination. This new method of sorting mail en route was developed just as the railroads were connecting every corner of the country. According to one of the listings in the Railroad Pictured Archives, this loco was originally built as an HSJ number 66 in 1892 at the CBQ shop in Aurora, Illinois, and became CBNQ number 359 when the CBQ took over control of the line. It was retired in 1932, but was rebuilt at Denver for the Century of Progress as BNMR number 35. Later, it was relettered as HNSTJ number 35. The wheel on the left is not a steering wheel. It is a brake wheel for the tender. The fireman sat on the left, but spent much of his time shoveling fuel into the firebox. This engine had no brakes. To stop, the engineer pushed the drive lever into reverse and whistled for a stop. A brakeman walked across the top of each car and tightened down the brakes wheels on each train car. The engineer sat on the right with his head out the window to see down the track. Trains have no steering wheels, they just follow the tracks.